In this section, we will learn a machine learning model that will be used to create a trading strategy. We will use the k-means clustering approach, which falls under the unsupervised learning algorithm category. In unsupervised learning algorithms, we let the algo automatically detect certain patterns in the data without manual labeling them. For instance, assume that you want the algo to predict the weather of a location. Using the historical data, the algo will learn to assign the data to clusters. Say sunny, rainy, and can predict the future data accordingly. Assume that we have a data set that can be divided into three clusters, as shown here. We can arrive at the number of clusters, either mathematically or by observation. For the sake of simplicity, let us assume that we can observe three clusters. To determine which data point belongs to which cluster, we initially assume three random data points as the cluster centers. The three centers are shown in three colors here. Calculate the distance of each data point to the three centers. And whichever distance is the least, we allot the data point to that cluster center. You can see three clusters here. Once we have finished clustering all the data points like this, we take the mean of all the data points in each cluster to generate new cluster centers. We keep repeating this process until no further changes take place in the clustering of data points. Now let us dive into the mathematics of this process. Let us say we have the temperatures in centigrade for a period of 8 days. We want to group them into two distinct datasets representing summer and rainy season. We start with two random data points as the centers of the two clusters. Say, 25.5 and 32. Next, each data point is assigned to its nearest centroid, based on the squared Euclidean distance. If two points P and Q with N features are represented as shown on the screen, then the Euclidean distance, D, from P to Q or from Q to P is given by this. We use this formula to calculate the distance between the cluster centers and the individual points, and assign the data point to the cluster with the minimum distance. Now we see that we are left with four data points in the cluster underscore one cluster, and four data points in the cluster underscore two cluster. After the two clusters are formed, we take the average of the data points in both the clusters separately, and assign these values to be the new centers for the two clusters. After this step, we repeat the processes in step 1 and step 2, using the new center values. We do this until one or all of the following criteria are satisfied. No more data points change clusters. The sum of the distances is minimized, or maximum number of iterations is reached. In this example, we have used only one variable, the temperature, to create the clusters, but in reality, while creating clusters, multiple parameters are used, and their Euclidean distance is calculated exactly as shown earlier. Let us revise some concepts about this algo in the upcoming multiple choice questions.